generics. We all want them, and they are probably not going to be built into PHP anytime soon. But there is proper support for generics using doc blocks, both by static analyzers like PHP Sten and SAM, but also, and this is a big one, by PHP Storm. You see, only a few months ago, PHP Storm added basic support for generics using doc blocks, and it does in fact work with quite a lot of cases. PHP Storm can tell us, in real time, while coding, what kind of generic types we're dealing with. It's even smart enough to infer generic types in some occasions. So if you have no clue what I'm talking about right now, I would suggest doing some reading on my blog. I've added some useful links in the description for you. But I also want to give an example. So here we have a kind of attribute class, a class that can filter and instantiate attributes. It provides a slightly cleaner API compared to straight up using PHP's built-in reflection classes. Now, after running this query here, I want my IDE to know in real time that I have an instance of the route attribute. And this is exactly the kind of complex example that PHP Storm is now able to detect, and it's a huge time saver. Now, let me show you the query itself, or at least the interesting parts. So here we have our attribute class with a generic attribute type, and that's the type that's returned by the first method in this example. Now the problem here, how do we actually set that generic type? It's actually pretty straightforward when you know about generic type inference. Here is our instance of method, and you can see it defines another generic type. It's called instance of type. Now PHP Storm and other static analyzers are smart enough to detect or infer the type of the input that's passed to this function. That's the name of the attribute we want to filter on. And it will use that type as the generic type for our attributes class when we return it. Now, this kind of generic type inference is an incredibly powerful tool. Now, you might need to read the examples a few times before getting it, but it essentially allows us to create classes like this attribute query class, where the end user still has lots of information available to them while using this package. Now, this is actually not what I wanted to talk about today. It's all pretty cool and I'm very excited about it, but if you know me, you know that I like to think about the details. And one of those details that we need to talk about, now that generics in PHP are much more accessible, is how to name them. So I used attribute type and instance of type as the generic type placeholders, but that's kind of not the convention in most programming languages. I looked at quite a lot of them, and by far the most popular convention, and I think that's thanks to Java, is to use a single letter for generic types. So T or E, V, K, U, those are some of the popular choices. And there are quite a lot of languages that follow this convention. Java, Kotlin, Rust, Go, also C Sharp and Swift. And I don't know about you, but I find that this makes my code so much harder to read. And the reasoning behind using these single letters is to make it clear by their name that these are generic types and not real types. But as you can see my screenshots here, you can very well just use a different color for generic types to differentiate them. Now, I need to mention though that PHP Storm doesn't support that yet, but I hope that they will change that after seeing this video. Another convention that I've seen around, especially in SAM and PHP Sten's documentation, is to prefix the generic name with an uppercase T. But I'm wondering, is that really more readable than suffixing it with type? T attribute or attribute type? T instance of or instance of type. The second one, it sounds much more like we'd say it in human language. So yeah, these are the kinds of details I'm thinking about because I feel like they genuinely affect the readability of my code and code of others that I need to work in. So I would like to know, what's your opinion? I made a poll on Twitter and I was completely surprised that so many people, more than 50%, preferred the single letter approach. That's terrible for code readability. Especially if you're working with multiple generic types within the same context. Anyway, I'll probably stick with what feels best for me and what I think is the most readable. But do share your opinions in the comments or on Reddit or Twitter wherever you're watching this. Maybe someone is able to change my mind, or maybe I just changed yours. Anyway, comment, like, subscribe, share, all the things. See you next time.